Hey Kelly, what do you call a fat pumpkin?
I don't know, what do you call a fat pumpkin?
A plumpkin!
Anyway, welcome to this week's Halloween episode of TNN.
So first up, we have music to improv.
You mean improv to music?
No, it's not music to improv.
It's actually
improv
to
music.
Improv
God, I don't know what it is. I don't know.
You are wrong.
No, you're wrong for being born.
No,
next up, we have Tanya reminding you about the color run.
Color run. Oh yeah. Oh
yeah. Hi, I'm Tanya, and today I interview a couple students that are going to be part of the color run. You guys started the Titan Challenge. What inspired you guys to do it?
Well, one of our Titan family members, Katie Rickenstein, has non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, and I think that we just kind of felt more inspired to participate, and especially as a large group, to raise as much money as we can, and we try to get more people to do it so we can just get more and more money to this fund or foundation.
What's your plan for Saturday? Are you guys going together as a group or?
Yes, all of us are going to get together and we're actually going to sing show tunes the entire way, so it's going to be a little interesting.
We'll probably get there on our own, but we'll probably run as a club. Anyone who decides to do it with us, we're all gonna dress up as cows, and we're gonna kinda like mosey through the course with someone dressed up as a farmer to like herd us through.
We're going to run around and chant and remember the Titans.
Honestly, we'll probably start as a group, but then we'll probably break off as we continue.
What do you guys hope to see Saturday, like out of the whole school community?
I'm hoping, and I think all of us are hoping, that we get a lot of people to come. So number one, it just shows how great of a family we are to support not only one Titan, but many other in this, there's many other people in the entire world, in fact, for this foundation.
You guys were challenged by who to run the color run?
The drama department.
Well, the football team actually challenged us to do it, and so personally, I was like, we need to do something cool because, I mean, we need to look good.
Okay. Well, thanks for talking to us, and we hope to see you Saturday. Thank you. The color run is going to be held this Saturday, the 29th, at 10 a.m. at the cross-country track, and the admission is $5 for students and $10 for adults.
Next up, we have another segment of the Whisper Challenge.
Kelly, they can't hear you. You gotta speak up.
The Whisper Challenge.
Hi, I'm Brayden Skinner, and I'm here with Chris Brady, and we're gonna be doing the Whisper Challenge, and we're gonna be going against Nikos and Travis. I'm jealous of my twin.
I'm Bryson Teller.
I'm jealous of my twin.
I'm Braxton Miller.
My interviewer is beautiful.
I don't know, I'm sorry.
Life is like a box of chocolates.
Left tackle.
Life is like a box of chocolates.
Life is like a box of chocolates?
Yeah. Jesus or president?
Jesus.
For president.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh. All right, you know who I am. This is Travis Brady. Brayden, you're going down. I'm jealous of my twin.
Something about chocolate and peanut butter.
I'm jealous of my twin.
First place.
My interviewer is beautiful.
Someone's beautiful.
My interviewer is beautiful.
Something about beautiful.
All right, skip that one. Life is like a box of chocolates.
Something about a shark.
Yeezus for president.
Fourth place.
That's it.
Brayden, you're going down.
Who's going down?
It's important.
We have breaking news.
Go over to construction update now!
Now it's time for the Tide Nation News construction update. I'm Ryan Wofford.
You guys, you're never gonna believe it! They're actually doing stuff back there!
Now to Bryce Glass. Well, what a spectacular current events. Right now, there's currently some mechanical beast over there, right now digging up some stuff. They're actually doing some, surprise, surprise. Over there, where we used to film, still nothing going on. It'll get done.
All right, so next up we've got Zach Barry's Halloween Spooktacular.
Kelly, is that the TMZ group?
Yeah.
Lucky guess.
My name's Zach Bagans. I believed in ghosts until I came face to face with one. So I set out on a quest to capture what I once saw onto video. With big camera crews following us around, I am joined only by my fellow investigator,
Lois Winson,
and our equipment tech,
Cameron Mattingly.
The three of us will travel to some of the most highly active paranormal locations where we will spend an entire night being locked down from dusk until dawn.
Did someone just scratch me?
Extreme. These are our ghost adventures.
All right, here we are in the auditorium. Kobe over there is getting dressed in some new ghost hunting gear he wants to try out. And once he's finished with that, we're gonna go hunt some ghosts.
See any ghosts?
No.
Oh, all right, cool.
See any ghosts?
Not today.
All right, cool, thanks.
Okay.
Man, no, dude.
All right, so I think there's a ghost in the elevator. Because you can hear people talking.
Maybe it's them over there.
Oh my God! Who are you?
My name is Zach Bagans. And I believed in ghosts until I came face to face with what I mean.
Dude, you want to go hunt some ghosts?
What do you say?
Is there a presence? Tell us your name. Did you hear that?
Let's play that back with audio that totally wasn't inserted later or anything.
Can you tell us your name?
No, Paul, stop. I want to do the voiceover.
Did you hear that?
Fine. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Run, dude, run. Oh my God, dude. Oh my God, Nick, run.
We've debunked that the spirit haunting the Welcome House is the ghost of an old evil TV show called TMZ.
Next up, we have a dramatic reading of Scary Stories.
With my man, the one and only, Corey Acker!
Thank you all for joining me. Monologue of Insanity, Confessions of a Stalker. Another day spent looking through my half-closed window, marveling at your strange beauty. There is not much I can say or do to get you, especially when I watch you from the roof. I follow you night and day, stalking you, admiring you, loving you. And yet not one glance is dedicated to me. Long days I've spent watching you and wanting you in the darkness of my room. I light candles upon your shrine. I smell your used scarf and whisper your name. All in the hopes that you'll become mine. Let us be here together alone. There is no escape. You know this, of course. nobody will love you as much as I do. I didn't want to do this, but your resistance is becoming annoying. I locked you up, I tied you down, and still you won't compliment me on my gown. 2 weeks you've been with me. I've been patient with your nasty attitude, your occasional murderous attempt, but last night I knew you had been too far bent. I screamed as I hacked your head off and laughed as it landed on the floor with a nice thud. I think that went pretty well.
Okay, Ryan, we've got our thesis statement.
We got our body paragraphs.
What's after that?
Oh, this is embarrassing.
A conclusion!
That's right. Miss Gerber will be so proud of you, Kelly.
Thanks for watching this week's episode of TNN.
Y'all folks, watch out for them clouds now.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from its slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise, did the monster mash. It was a graveyard smash. It caught on in a flash. He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrodes. Then you can monster mash, and do my graveyard smash. You'll catch on in a flash. Then you can monster mash.